In this video, I want to tell you about a very big corner case around this count aggregate function. So I'm going to delete the query that we have for right now, and I'm going to replace it with a select star from photos. I'm then going to run this, and we're going to take a look at a list of all the different photos we have. Remember, there's about 20 photos or so. At some point in time in the previous videos, we also added in an extra photo right here. It looks like we have 21 photos in total. And I just want to remind you that the last photo that we added in does not have a user ID associated with it. It has a null value right there. Now, let's try something really interesting. I want to count up the number of photos we have. We're not going to worry about doing any group by. We're just going to do an aggregate function by itself. So I'm going to do a select count user ID from photos. I'm then going to run that. And you'll notice that we got 20 here, even though we just saw that there were 21 photos inside of our photos table. So what's going on? Well, whenever we do a count on a column, null values are not counted. So that 21st photo has a user ID of null. That does not increment our value. So we don't count that inside this count user ID. To get around that, because usually you're going to want to include all photos when you're trying to find a count, rather than referencing any particular column, you can instead put in count star, like so. And that means just count up the total number of rows. Don't look at any particular column, just count the number of rows. So if we run this, we now see the correct 21. Now we can go back and update the query that we were looking at just a moment ago, where we had select user ID, count star from comments, and then once again we can group by user ID. And so if we run that, we get probably the same result as we did before. I can't recall if we had any comments with a null user ID. You could always double check that on your own if you want to. But in general, whenever we make use of count, we're going to use star instead of referencing any particular column. Again, just so we can safely deal with this problem of possibly having null values. Now, there might be some scenarios where you do not want to count null values, but that's really up to you to decide how you want to deal with that or the specific problem you're working on. All right, so just a little corner case around count that you need to be aware of. Let's take a pause here and then start doing some more practice around group by and these aggregate functions in the next video.